Graph the function f of x equals 2x squared minus 4x plus 3. Okay, now this quadratic function is in standard form. So we need to find the coordinates of the vertex here first. Now the x coordinate of the vertex is equal to negative b over 2a. And remember, a is the coefficient for the x squared, b is the coefficient for the x, and then c is the 3, or the constant term. So we need to find out the x coordinate of the vertex first. And the b value is negative 4, so x equals the negative of negative 4 divided by 2 times a, which is 2. So that simplifies to negative times negative 4 is just 4, and then divided by 2 times 2, which is also 4, equals 1. So the x value of the vertex is 1. And the y value we don't know yet. But you can find out by substituting the 1 in for x. You put the input for 1, and your output for f of x is going to be the y value, or the vertical value, of the vertex. So f of 1 equals 2 times 1 squared minus 4 times 1 plus 3. So f of 1 equals, and 1 squared is simply 1, so it's going to be 2 times 1, minus 4 times 1, plus 3. And then let's simplify further. F of 1 equals, 2 times 1 is 2, and then negative 4 times 1 is negative 4, then plus 3. So F of 1 equals 2 minus 4, which is negative 2, and then plus 3. So F of 1 equals 1. Okay, well, that was a lot of work to get the 1 value. So our vertex is at 1, 1, right there. And notice there's no vertical reflection because of positive 2 for the x squared term. And that 2 does mean it's stretched by 2. So we're going to go right 1 and then up 2 times 1 squared, which is 2. And then we're going to go right 2. And then we're going to go up 2 times 2 squared, which is 8. So right 2, and then up 8, 2, 4, 6, 8, right there. And I'm going to stop because the next value, let's say we take a 3, so we go 3 right. Then we have to do 2 times 3 squared, which would actually be 2 times 9, or 18. That's way up off there. So now I'm simply going to reflect through the axis of symmetry, which is the vertical line x equals 1. Here we go. And these are the points that we need to draw the parabola. All right, so there's the graph of the function. And you probably want to check on your calculator whenever you draw a graph by hand just to make sure. This is the process that you use to graph when you have a quadratic function in standard form.